that Adam in Chelsea first. So, Adam, your reaction to what's happening in New Zealand. Good morning.
Oh, hello, good morning. I just wanted to say that it's happening because of the rise in xenophobia. A lot of people can't understand what Islam is all about, and they get the wrong end of the stick, and they just completely lose the plot. And I would blame you and another presenter on your station who are just, you know, peddling this hate for political gains. We need to stop this before something like this happens there.
Sorry, I just get this straight. A colleague was talking to me. I'm to blame for the New Zealand shootings, am I?
Likes of you, I would say.
Right. Okay. This is an interesting
one. In the
one.
Media.
Okay. What have I done that makes someone take a gun to a mosque in New Zealand?
You know, peddling xenophobia, peddling hate.
In New Zealand?
Yes. We're living in a global world today. People over there
see.
Listen to you.
Right.
And people in America listen to you.
Right. Okay. And how do I peddle xenophobia?
Well, I would love to play you your clips that, you know...
Well, you don't have to. I don't expect you to get it word for word. Just give me the broad brush strokes.
Well, there's so much. I just can't...
Well, just give me one.
So much. I wish I could have, you know, written it down and I could just...
Wait, no, as I say, sir, I'm not asking you to nail it word for word. Just give me a broad brush strokes of what I've said.
Okay, I'll give you a general example. Whenever something, you know, whenever a Muslim commits a crime, instead of dealing with the crime itself, the emphasis and the spotlight is put on the fact that the guy is a Muslim. So you see, when you do stuff like that, it generates hate against.
So is it's when I say facts, is it? That's the problem.
No. It's the way you say a fact. It's the way you portray.
It's the way I say
there's a way of dishing out propaganda, and you know it better than me.
Ah, so giving someone's faith, which is a fact, and might have wrongly...
A crime is a
and
crime,
might
man.
Have wrongly led him to take the action he did. That,
that's... Dealing with him as a criminal.
Pardon?
It's got nothing to do with his religion.
No, but he thinks it... I agree with you, but he thinks it does. And that's why it's important we bring that out, Adam.
Who thinks it does?
Many people misrepresent the faith of Islam, and that is why they blow themselves up, or they blow children up who are coming out of a pop concert, or they try and blow up tube trains, because they misrepresent the faith of Islam. They think they're doing it for that reason. We have to get that out there.
Okay, what would you say about this guy? Do you think he represents Christianity?
Which guy?
The guy who's...
This is very, very early day. He might think he does, but I'm damn certain he doesn't. But what's going on? Well, you say he, actually, I think it's they. I have no idea what's going on in their heads, but if this is what they think is Christianity, just as that...
I refuse to believe that you don't know what's going on in their head. You know what's going on in their head, and
okay.
You created this demon.
Okay, I created the demons. All right, I think we've probably had about as long... Mohammed in Birmingham. What are you going to tell me, Mohammed? Good morning.
Good morning, Nick. Hi there. First of all, I want to say how horrified I am of this... attacking has happened. Equally horrified that Adam actually accused you of being responsible for the attack and the media, which is absolutely absurd.
Yes, well, thank you.
I find that absolutely disgusting. My concerns are, and I have warned of this attack many a times. We are heading towards where it's going to be tit for tat. I'm afraid that the churches in the UK and across the world will be under attack as a target now. As a practicing Christian, I am concerned of that now, because we're going to have the same situation here in the UK as we did in Ireland, where two communities were at war with each other, tit-for-tat killings. And this is what we need to prevent. And I think,
how is it to be prevented, Mohammed?
How is it to prevent it? I think what we can do at the moment is start with stop de-platforming individuals that critique Islam, because when you do that, you are pushing people underground. When you push people underground, they will react in a different way. It's important that we allow people to critique Islam and vent their anger on social media. If we don't, we are pushing them underground, and we are in danger of pushing people towards this way.
Mohammed, thank you for your input. Have yourself a safe day. We'll continue with this conversation in a moment. Actually, let me just bring you this. Just been handed to me, the London Mayor.